Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be working on organic bubble design. First, we'll create out the organic shapes using the web option and create a mesh. Then, create our cluster of bubbles with all the tiny details in Illustrator and set up the composition in Photoshop. So let's begin with the tutorial. Select the ellipse tool and draw out a circle. Apply dark blue color from the swatches. Now with the alt press, just click and drag to create 5 more duplicates. We'll give organic shapes to each circle. Select the first circle and go to Object, Envelope Distort, Make with Wrap. Wrap option panel will appear. Change the style to Arc Lower. Next, adjust the blend, horizontal and vertical sliders to distort the circular shape. Set the blend to 30%, horizontal to -32% and the vertical to -12% and click OK. In the same way, we'll modify all the other circles. Select the second circle and open Wrap option panel. Change the style to Inflate and give blend to 8%, horizontal to -17% and the vertical to -13%. Set the values and styles for 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th. Once distorting all these circles, select all the shapes and go to Object, Expand to expand all these shapes. Next, we'll apply gradient mesh to give volume to each object. So select the shape and go to Object, Create Gradient Mesh. Under Gradient Mesh panel, give 4x4 rows and columns. Do this for all the other shapes. Next, select individual shapes and apply gradient color. Select the vertices from the mesh using the direct selection tool, then apply light blue color from the color panel. To give a volume, select all the border vertices and apply dark blue color. We can select individual vertices and add secondary shades. In the same way, apply gradient color to all the rest of the organic shapes. Make sure to add highlights according to their volume. So, we are done with all the adjustments. Next, we are ready to create the bubbles using these organic shapes. Before we begin, select all the shapes and open Transparency panel. There, change the mode to Multiply. Now, let's arrange the bubbles on a new artboard. Adjust the size and rotation to create a cluster of bubbles. Try to put different shapes together to get more natural look. Once we are done with all the big bubbles, let's add some small bubbles on the either sides. Place them randomly over the areas. And lastly, we'll add some glossy bubbles. Place the shape over the bubbles, then change the mode to screen. This will add a shiny bubble effect. Add few more shiny bubbles over these areas. Don't forget to arrange them to front. And finally, we are done with the vector organic bubble design. Next, let's open the new Photoshop document to create out the bubble scene. So select the bubbles and drag and drop to Photoshop. Scale up the size and place it around here. Add a new brightness and contrast adjustment layer. Set the brightness value to -12 and the contrast value to 8. Then add hue and saturation adjustment layer. Here, set the hue value to -8 and the saturation value to 7. Next, we'll add a new layer for color dodge. So add a new layer, change the layer mode to color dodge. Now using the soft brush tool with the blue color selected, apply the color dodge. Add the color over here, here and here. This will add up a nice glossy effect over the bubbles. Apply it over the areas where you want to give enhancement. Then reduce the layer opacity to 70%. Group up the two layers with a shortcut Command or Control G. Now open the Illustrator file and select few of the bubbles. Drag and drop to Photoshop. We'll use this for BG bubbles. Place the layer and scale up the size. We'll add a new layer for color dodge. Select the soft brush tool and apply color dodge over the areas. Select the two layers and group it up. We can reduce the number of bubbles in this layer, so open the group and double click on this smart object. This will open up a file in Illustrator. delete out few of the bubbles and save the file. It will automatically update some Photoshop document. Adjust the rotation and size, select the layer and apply Gaussian blur. Set the radius value to around 6.8 pixel and click OK. You can also add a more color dodge to add more highlights. Next, add a new layer for the background. Apply a gradient color of white and dark blue using the gradient tool. Then reduce the layer opacity to 37%. And lastly, type out a text, apply proper font for the text, scale the size, add highlights, and place them with the alignment. Finally, we have completed designing the organic bubbles. We have understood the proper use of wrap option, gradient mesh, and color dodge. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.